Jill, we are so pleased to have you with us today. NASCAR made its welcome return over the weekend, the Real Heroes 400. Kevin Harvick, your winner, 6.3 million viewers. That is a number. I want to get your first and initial overall takeaways.
Yeah, I mean, thanks for having me. A huge day for us. You know, we knew coming back racing, it was going to be a big day. We were going to be in front of a lot of eyeballs, either core NASCAR fans that were dying to have us come back or some new fans that just wanted sports back. And they came, they showed up. We were able to put NASCAR racing in front of all of those millions of fans, and we put on a great show. So really excited about how it went.
It really was terrific to watch. Take us through some of the precautions and the process of putting them in place prior to the race and even during.
We took a lot of care in trying to find out the right way to go back racing. We knew that there's a lot of responsibility attached to that. You know, we had to protect our competitors, our drivers, our industry, but we also had to protect the local communities that we were racing in. In this case, Darlington. We know that across the country there have been a lot of hardships, and we had to make sure that we didn't come in and add to any issues, that we were actually really prepared and ready to go. So a ton of logistical planning went into that, a screening of all of our competitors, separation, making sure they're all wearing all of the protective gear, and really social distancing. And it seems easy with all the messaging you see nowadays, but it was kind of taking all of those protocols and applying them to 900 people in a racetrack. The good thing for us is our facilities are very large, so we had the ability to keep people separate, and everybody did their part to maintain that safety.
So race day is approaching. Come race day, did you encounter some surprises along the way?
Well, I think it was for all of us. I mean, the drivers, I'm guessing, always have butterflies before they strap into the car. But I think for all of us at NASCAR, we had those same butterflies. You know, we knew that there was going to be a lot of attention, and we needed to do it right. And I think that really it came off, planning, really paid off and allowed us to execute properly. We had a lot of scenario planning leading up to it. We all had a job to do, and everybody executed. And the great news is the fan watching at home, I don't think, other than a little bit odd seeing drivers wearing masks in victory lane or crew guys during their pit stops, you still got a great NASCAR race. And if you're in the middle of the race, you didn't really notice that hopefully there was much of a difference.
That's exactly what several of the drivers said. You know, once you're on the track and you're running around that oval, you're not thinking about the crowd, right?
Yeah. I mean, I think that they strap in and they're in their zone anyway, like any competitor. So they're just kind of tunnel vision. I think the one thing that you did hear Kevin Harvick say in victory lane is, he gets out to do his burnout and he looks around and there's nobody there. And I think so. Some of it was a little surreal. It was an interesting mix of kind of change and then going back to what you always know.
Well, the product was terrific. We saw that ratings increase, which was tremendous. A lot of large markets as well, we saw that increase in. So, oftentimes in challenges comes opportunity. This is an opportunity for NASCAR to continue to raise its profile.
Absolutely. I mean, we knew that this was a chance for us to put NASCAR racing in front of fans that maybe hadn't tried us before. Big markets, we had a lot of sports fans that were hungry for sports to come back. I think we've all learned as Americans that our sports are very, we knew it was important. But it was a chance to really showcase, we know that NASCAR has great storylines and unbelievable entertainment, but this was a chance to really showcase that to a much wider audience. And, I think that it turned out really well.
Safety is one of the big storylines in play. You recognize the healthcare workers and the frontliners in a very innovative way. Take us through that.
Yeah, it was a project, 14 different sports leagues got together when we all kind of knew that competition wasn't going to be what it once was, and really tried to figure out how we could recognize or use the power of sports even when we weren't playing or racing. And so this ability to recognize these frontline healthcare workers who are the heroes in this situation, and for us, take our drivers out of it and say, we're not the heroes, it's these frontline healthcare workers, and replace you know, drivers' names on the side of the door with the healthcare worker. You saw Kevin Harvick recognize his friend who was a doctor here in Charlotte. You know, we really felt like it was appropriate for us to take the sport of NASCAR and our drivers out of it and really recognize the people that allowed us to go back to race. And it was a really great campaign and a really something I'm really proud to be a part of.
It looked like that was a real focus for you to make sure that you honored these people. Fair to say?
Yeah, we knew really early on that we had to take a different tone, that if we went back racing the same way we always did, that it would feel a little odd. And what better way to use this national platform than to recognize the people that weren't getting the recognition or that deserve the recognition. So it was just very natural. And, you know, our drivers embraced it and the fans really, really paid attention to it.
I'm curious, after the fact, have you had a chance to speak to some of the drivers about their experience that day?
Yeah, I mean, you know, we've got a group here that talks to them each and every day. They're helping us promote. You know, this is kind of uncharted territory for all of us. And the drivers have been great. You know, the fact that they were able to talk about the healthcare worker that they were partnered with, it really gave them something that they could showcase. So they were feeling really good about it. We're doing it again this week, tonight, actually, one more race in Darlington. And then we kind of shift our focus to recognizing military members over Memorial Day at the Coca-Cola 600, which is something we do, you know, at this time every year. So it'll be a natural transition.
You have put out a revised schedule, a much tighter schedule, of course. It looks like also that the focus was on keeping travel to a minimum.
Yeah, you know, we are constantly monitoring what's happening across the country in the different markets. We know that, like everybody, that there are certain places that are harder hit by this pandemic and how each community is reacting to that. And we also have a responsibility to, as I mentioned before, to keep our competitors safe. So putting them onto airplanes or into hotels just wasn't something that we thought was the prudent way to go right now. So you see a very aggressive schedule from now through June, but all at venues that the drivers and the teams who are predominantly located here in Charlotte can drive to. So keeping that travel to a minimum, exposure to different folks to a minimum, and keeping those protocols in place. So it's aggressive, but you know, we're ready. We know that people want to go back racing, and that's what we do. So we're ready to do it, and whatever means necessary.